Okay, we are going to teach you the latest, greatest model of the atom. So this handout kind of shows you the evolution of it. In another screencast, I'll talk more about that. We are going to learn in your packets kind of a board game. And so here are the rules to the game. Grab my arrow. Electrons will land in the lowest energy orbital available. Energy levels are like floors, and in each floor there's some sublevels, so we just need to recognize that as a term. And then orbitals, and orbitals are like chairs. So it's probably best to actually just play the game and then figure out how these terms apply. So I actually want to go to this screen right here, hydrogen. So energy level 1 has one sublevel, it's called an S. And in that S orbital, there's two spots for electrons to land. Energy level 2, there are two sublevels. There's some S and there's some P's. The S orbital is sphere-shaped, just like the 1S. And now we have new ones we call P orbitals. They're dumbbell-shaped. Then we have an energy level 3, three sublevels, S, P, D. And again, S's are sphere-shaped. P's are dumbbell shaped. The D's we won't talk about, they get complicated. So, actually we back up. We're gonna make an element. It's going to be hydrogen, number 1, hydrogen. So there's 3 rules. Let me back up a screen, see if I can find it. Here, rules to filling. If you read this, these are the 3 rules you need to pay attention. Electrons must fill the lowest sublevel orbital available. If they're in the same orbital, they must have opposite spin. And in P orbitals, there's a specific rule. You have to put 1 electron in each orbital before you double up. So again, this will make more sense when we actually start building these elements. So, we hit play here. This electron is going to come down. Can't land in 3P, it can go lower, 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 till finally it lands at the lowest energy available, the 1S. So the 1S orbital, once again, is a sphere shape. It's like a cloud, it's a place where electrons can exist. And there's only 1 electron in that cloud. And so what we say for hydrogen is the 1S orbital has 1 electron. 1S1, go ahead, try and say it. All right, let's do helium. All right, helium, same thing. We have a bunch of empty orbitals, energy levels. And here comes an electron. We need to put 2 electrons in. Helium has 2 electrons. So the first electron lands in the 1s. Second one has an up spin. Can't do that. It's not stable. So the second electron must have an opposite spin. So we show that with the arrow going up, arrow going down. And so we say for helium, the electron configuration is 1s2. The 1s orbital has 2 electrons in it. Try saying that. Helium is 1s2. All right. Let's go on to the next one, lithium. Lithium, we need 3 electrons because lithium has 3 electrons. Same game. Let's hit play. The 1s orbital, sphere-shaped. We'll have electrons land, 1 up, second one down. So that's the 1s2. We need a third electron. The next energy that's available, orbital that's available, is the 2s orbital. And now it has 1 electron. So we say 1s2, 2s1. Okay, lithium is 1s2, 2s1. Let's build the next element. Number 4, beryllium. We're starting off already with some electrons that we just had, the 1s2, 2s1. So that's lithium. We need 4 electrons. Okay. So the next electron comes in. You can't have an up-up. It's got to have opposite spins, up-down. You just made beryllium. 1s2. 2s2 is how we say it. Number 5, we need 5 electrons. So we still have 1s has 2, 2s has 2. So now this is a big moment. in your life, let's look at this 2p orbital. That's the next available orbital available for an electron to land. So that electron tries to land energy 3, but there's a lower one, 2p. The 2p has one electron. So we say 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, boron, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. All right, let's go to the next one. Carbon. Carbon's number 6. So we have a new rule, that third rule that involves the p orbitals. When I hit play, you could try putting the electron in that 2p orbital right next to the other one, but no, there's room right next door. There's an empty orbital. In fact, there's two empty orbitals. So it's up, up. We say up, down, up, down, up, up. 1s has two electrons, 2s has two electrons, 2p has two electrons. 1s2, say it with me. 2s2, let's start from the beginning. 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, 2, 4, 6, 6 electrons. That makes carbon. Number 7. We have 2 already in the 1s, 2 already in the 2s, 2 already in the 2p. If you look closely, there's room for one more electron in that empty orbital. Actually, there's room for 2. There's lots of room still. So when an electron comes in, that's a natural space for it to land in that 2p orbital, the third one. So we say 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Okay, so now something interesting happens when we go to our next element, oxygen. Okay, if you look close, 1s is full, 2s is full. The 2p orbitals have an up, up, up. So now we have room to put down electrons in. So the next electron that can fill, remember you can't have up, up. Can't have up, up. Nope, not there. Gotta have an up, down electron. So what do we say? We say 1s2, say it with me, 2s2, 2p4. The 2p orbital has 4 electrons. It's that simple. All right, let's fill the next ones. Fluorine, I'll just hit play. I've jumped to number 9. Fluorine has 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. We need one more electron in there. So let me bring this one down. 5, because that's the number of fluorine, 2p5. Okay? All right. Neon, number 10. We need 10 electrons. So we fill up our bottom ones first, 1s2, 2s2, and then 2p6. So we say, because this 2p and 2s orbitals are full, this is a very stable element. You may have heard that, the noble gases, the neon, argon, etc., are very stable. And that has a lot to do with this 2s orbital being full and the 2p orbital being full. So guess what the pattern is? We go to energy level 3, and you're going to just do exactly what you did with energy level 2. You fill the 2s up first, so you'll fill the 3s up. 3p's, you'll go up, up, up. Then you'll double up, down, down, down. So your challenge is to figure out the electron configuration for that third row. Starting with sodium, that'll be your next element. Good luck.